So here we have example, and here I have taken the plate, and we are considering here we have sigma 1 and here we have sigma 2. So from previous class we easily understand how to find out the diameter of the boom, how to find out the diameter of the boom. Now what are the things you can expect? One is moment of inertia, how to find out moment of inertia, and another thing you can expect, how to find out bending stress. This is what we are going to calculate when you bother about GATE exam, not for the university level. In case of university level, we do a lot with this kind of thin sections. Now see, from very basic idea of moment of inertia, when I was taking very basic idea in the class, I told you this, I is equal to AR square is going to be your formula, or I is equal to MR square is going to be your formula to find out moment of inertia. Now see, this moment of inertia you will find out if only small area is known. So this is known as area moment of inertia, and here you have mass moment of inertia, because your object will rotate only because of two things, either because of area or because of this mass. Just an example, how area is responsible for the rotation, I will tell you. Suppose you have one small rod, and suppose this rod is very much dense and its mass is imagine 100 kg, just 100 kg, and imagine it is very dense. So suppose you are blowing air, so this guy will not rotate because it is not having sufficient sufficient area so that air can hit the area. Then do one thing, I am trying to teach that how area is responsible for the rotation. So for that purpose, you do one thing, you have this rod, right? Just beat the rod by hammer and make it flat, okay? Then same air, and one more thing, you put hinge here, then same air you blow here, then what will happen, the entire thing can rotate. So this is one idea where you can achieve, where you can learn how area can be responsible for the rotation. So we have area moment of inertia. So these two formulas are the basic formulas. So you can see here you have an area, okay, and if you'll apply any load here, it may have tendency to rotate about neutral axis. And here you have an area, if you apply load, it may have tendency to rotate about this axis, okay. You may have different y values, like y1 here and y2 here, or you may have same y values. So if you want to find out moment of inertia of this guy, how will you find out? Simply, moment of inertia is equal to area of this boom and r means y square. I mean about neutral axis it is rotating, so that is your y square. And how will you find out moment of this boom? Same way, area of this boom and the moment of inertia, and this distance y. So I1, I2. In last class, I taught you how to find out B1 and B2. B1 and B2 are the diameters of the boom, right? So by using that formula, you will find out diameter, and then from the diameter, you will find out your area. And once area is known, then by using this logic, you can find out moment of inertia. So this is how you can calculate moment of inertia. So based on this, we have type 2 also, how to find out bending stress. You can easily find out bending stress if you know how to find out moment of inertia by using that bending equation, flexural equation. But let's understand one question where we are going to tackle this type 1, okay? So take the question.